Welcome back again to our exploration of Orion's arm. Today, we are going to be talking about a form of life that is very alien to what we are used to. In order to find these life forms, we must travel to the Einstein's Revenge Cluster. It is a cluster of neutron stars located far, far into space. Now, to find what we are looking for, we must go deep inside of these neutron stars. Let's pick this one. This neutron star is called KJEI-54458945. We must find the superfluid outer core of this star. This layer is filled with a substance called nuclear pasta. In this region, the star's rotation and magnetic field are quantized. Neutron vortex filaments carry a single unit of angular momentum each, while proton vortex filaments carry a single unit of magnetic flux. These filaments interact with each other through attractive and repulsive magnetic forces, and form complex knots due to quantum turbulence. Two filaments of the same type connect on contact, and this releases Kelvin waves. There are more left-handed electrons than right-handed electrons inside neutron stars, and this leads to spin currents of left-handed electrons traveling along proton vortex filaments, which changes the forces between filaments. These simple processes lead to more complex life-like processes. Filaments, when braided together, can store energy and information. Kelvin waves can also be used for signaling. These braided threads can become capable of self-replication, kind of like our own cells. And when these threads bundle together, they can form complex life forms. Sort of like how on Earth, cells form more complex tissues and organs. There is a whole ecosystem based off of these knots and threads, which is around 50 times smaller and faster than the one found on Earth. One of the species found here is known as the Hildemar's knots. Producers in this ecosystem gain energy from neutron vortex filaments in the crust, since there is a different rotational speed between the interior and the crust of the star. These producers, called rototrophs, are anchored to the crust and gain energy from releasing neutron vortex filaments from the crust. Consumers absorb energy from the producers, either by being parasitic, directly absorbing from other organisms, or breaking apart other organisms. There is also a simple chromatic biosphere inside of the inner core of neutron stars, which gains energy from the temperature gradient. Hildemar's knots have a main body that is a torus knot, which can extend, elongate, and contract. This body is only around 2 to 4 centimeters at its maximum length. Around this body, flexible limbs are coiled, which have many digits and cilia which can touch and feel. They use these limbs to ensnare plankton and eat them. Kelvin waves and spin currents are used to send signals throughout the body of a knot. The nervous system of knots is distributed along different points of their body, and the limbs are autonomous and can act independently. When knots contract, their limbs can connect with each other easier and can rearrange and shift their minds. Two individuals can link to form a feeding mesh, which allows the knots to act as one entity. Through this, individuals can share thoughts, memories, and personality traits. They can even change the sex, thoughts, and personalities of the other individual. Knots move through the star using the specialized movements through the flow of the star. They can also sense the turbulence of the area to determine what animals moved through the area. All knots are born male, but can become female after reaching sexual maturity. Knots mate by growing threads from their body and connecting them. Then, they untangle from each other, and this creates an offspring which is attached to the mother. After 10 days, it separates. Knots live around 2 years on average, going by Terran standard, of course. Knots are good at coordinating with each other and forming tight-knit groups. Knot society is based off transferring personality traits from individual to individual. It is also based off the concepts of orthodoxy and noise. Orthodoxy represents the social orders and behaviors among the group that members are expected to follow, and noise represents new behaviors and personality traits that are not established among the group. Knots make art using the turbulence of filaments. Knots can also manipulate ecological variables in order to make more plankton for themselves, as they understand ecology and mathematics well and can create accurate models of turbulence. They also understand that their star is spinning. The knots may have had more advanced technology in the past, as their biosphere was somehow able to colonize the 6 stars of the Einstein's Revenge Cluster. The Hildemar's knots were discovered in 9837 AT by the Harupta Investigatory Fleet. Data from the fleet shows that all of the biospheres share a common ancestry and diverged around 1.3 million years ago. It could be that some other civilization created them and put them in the stars, or that this civilization copied a naturally evolved ecosystem on one star and put it in all the other stars of the Einstein's Revenge cluster. It is also possible that the Hildemar's knots actually were more technologically advanced in the past. Whatever the case, Hildemar's knots are very interesting creatures who live in an interesting biosphere. We hope you will join us as we explore more interesting creatures and interesting biospheres and ecosystems across the galaxy. But for now, thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe and do all those YouTube things. Goodbye.